Beloved in Christ Jesus, greetings to you all in the most blessed name of the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Today's meditation theme is Jesus of Nazareth, King of Jews, of the day 27 in the Lenten meditation series. I have taken from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 19, verse 19. Nameplate is an identity of a person, name with the address and the profession attached to it gives the complete whereabouts of a person. Every nation has its own system of recording the identity of a person. The nation of Israel, ruled by the Roman Empire, also had a unique way of identification process. In reference to Luke chapter 2, 1 to 5, the encounter with Pilate, the governor in the inquiry, the kingdom concept and the truth factor, along with the question of authority of Pilate over Jesus. Reference John 18. The narration in this could be one of the reasons for the nameplate. Pilate probably upheld the identity system of the Roman government in attaching name of the place Nazareth as the suffix followed by his profession, the kingship. Let us ponder three things upon this title. The inscription. The placard depicts the crime of the accused. The print on the placard, Jesus of Nazareth, the King of Jews, which Pilate had inscribed, was opposed and protested by the Jewish clergy. They wanted it as the one who claimed as I am the King of the Jews. But Pilate trusted it authoritatively. Pilate did this in order to insult and embarrass them, and also it was probably the answer he received by Jesus for his questions found in John chapter 18. In support of Pilate's act of placard, the Roman soldiers had crowned him with the thorn's twig and clothed him with a purple robe, which declared him ironically or as a matter of mockery to the Jews at the very outset. The purpose of using three languages is Hebrew, that is Aramaic, being the language of the Jewish religion, Greek, the language of the common people, and the Latin, that of the law, the government. Pilate's aim was that the fact should be known to all the world, as it was a cosmopolitan city of his day. On the cross was the inscription, the King of Jews. From Marcus J. Bog's point of view, the inscription was ironic. Pilate attended it as rejection and most likely saw it as a mocking, not only to Jesus but to his accusers also, as if to say, this person whom Rome has the power to execute is your king or some king. Yet from the vantage point of view, the presence in the story reminds us that the crucifixion was specifically for the people who systematically refused to accept the Roman empirical authority. Ordinary criminals were not executed, crucified, but Jesus was executed as a rebel against Rome between two other rebels against Rome. The second one is the accusation. Pilate's interrogation of Jesus, as recorded in John 18, deals with two things particularly based on the accusation as traitor, accused as the enemy of the state, blasphemy. The second one is the blasphemy. Matthew chapter 26, verse 25 to 68, claiming as Christ. Jewish religious council accused Jesus guilty of these two major things, and also the religious leaders did not hesitate to condemn the innocent man based on the charges made by the Jewish council. The three official charges made by them were: he led the nation astray, second one, he opposed paying tribute to Caesar, third one, he claimed to be the Jewish Messiah and the king. Third one, the decree. Pilate was not anxious to involve in a Jewish religious case, that too particularly during the Passover time. In fact, Pilate was trying to escape from this issue. From this interrogation, it looks like he wanted to please the Jewish community. Had he not supported the Jewish plea, he had the fear of being thrown out of the governorship, because the Jews were complaining against him of being enemy to Caesar. On the other hand, at least in three times, he announced that Jesus was not guilty of any crime. Luke chapter 23:14, John 19:4, and Luke chapter 23:22. Yet, without releasing him, he washed his hands. Pondering on these questions asked by Pilate to Jesus, this is John 18:33-34, are you the king of Jews? This question irked Pilate himself, as Jesus answered the question by posing or throwing back a question to him for clarity. Do you have this idea on your own, or did someone informed or instigated you regarding my kingship? The fact, in the first accusation made by the Jews as Jesus the traitor, and that Jesus was trying to topple the Roman government, could have made Pilate to ask the question, but the accusation as a traitor was a hypocritical move by the religious sect to get rid of Jesus without getting ceremonially defiled. During this Passover season, although altogether these facts could have inspired Pilate for the inscription as the king of Jews. Pilate's another question of knowing the truth, where Jesus answered in a divine perspective, and born in Bethlehem and grew up in Nazareth, this lowly village which was crowded with the people, bonded laborers from eastern countries, which depicted a humble human nature of Jesus. Finally, I am not of this world, a kingdom that involved kingdom dynamics and kingdom value, that is the truth. All these facts would have inspired Pilate to inscribe as Jesus of Nazareth. Ultimately, he found no guilt in him. But Pilate could have felt that he had been completely convinced and satisfied about the inscription and judgment: Jesus of Nazareth, the King of Jews. Reflection: the inscription on the cross had completely convinced Pilate in the worldly sense, but in the real sense, unknowingly, he gave the divine plan of God through Jesus. Today, we see more or less the same situations and issues that we come across in our day-to-day lives. The false accusations made to sideline or to completely eradicate the people of truth, or living in the light of the kingdom values, are vibrant in the world. Hypocritical way of living in order to accomplish vested interests, like that of Jewish community, which is in the dominant caste system of our society. The religious threats due to mass conversions or convictions, rather labeled as community of conversion, which is a false accusation. The religious group of those days of Jesus feared the monetary loss of the temple rather than in hope of redemption of the people, which we see in the society of our days. Let us pray. Almighty God, help us to discern the things happening around us in this world in the light of the scriptures, and to enlighten the church with the right perspective and live a meaningful life to do His perfect will in the days to come. Amen.